You have a YouTube channel about algorithms and data structures, like this one, and you want to talk about a lot of topics. But you want to keep things ordered, so before talking about a subject, you want to cover its prerequisites. For example, before talking about Dijkstra's algorithm, you want to cover graph introduction and priority queues. And before talking about priority queues, you want to cover queues and binary heaps, and so on. But the problem is that now, you don't know what order to follow, you don't know which topic to cover before which to make sure that when covering a topic, all the prerequisites are already covered. And here comes the topological sort algorithm, an algorithm that orders the nodes of a directed acyclic graph in a way such that for every edge from U to V, U comes before V in the ordering. To see how it works, let's apply it to this directed acyclic graph. Let's start from this node. Orange means that it's already visited. Now we visit every neighbor. Let's start by this one. Same thing here, we visit every neighbor. Let's start by this one. This node has D only as a neighbor. Let's go to it. Now D has no neighbors, so we already finished traversing its neighbors. We can push it onto the stack, and we backtrack. We visited all the neighbors of C, so we push it, and we backtrack. B still has one unvisited neighbor, F, we go to it. D is visited, but E is not. E has no neighbors, we push, and we backtrack. We visited all neighbors of F, we push, and we backtrack. Same thing for B, we push, and we backtrack. Back to G, F is already visited, so we finished, and we push. G was the node we started with, and we finished the depth first search traversal, but we still have unvisited nodes, so we continue. We still have A, and all its neighbors are visited, so we directly push. You can see that all nodes are visited, so we finished. Now that we finished traversing the whole graph, we just keep popping from the stack. And we got our topological order A, G, B, F, E, C, D. Note that it's not the only possible ordering, we could have another one that is also valid. Now we've seen how does it work, but it's also interesting to know what we exactly did here, what's the logic behind this algorithm. Here we use a stack such that every element in it comes before all the ones under it. This is why we waited until we reach a node that has no neighbors to insert in the stack. Because if we insert it as soon as we visit a node, the next one will be on top of it, which is wrong because the next node comes after it in the ordering, not before. Is the reason why we insert a vertex U in the stack after visiting all the neighbors, to make sure that all the nodes whose U is a prerequisite are under it in the stack. Before moving to the code, let me just tell you why topological sort works on directed acyclic graphs only. A graph that has cycles can't have a topological order, because for example for this cycle, A has to come before B, B has to come before C, and C has to come before A, which is impossible. Let's move to the code. We first need a recursive function to perform the depth first search traversal. It takes as parameters the graph, the actual vertex, the set of visited vertices, and the stack. We first set the actual vertex to visited, then we visit every neighbor. To do so, for each neighbor, if it's not visited, we recursively call the function on it to visit it. After doing so, as explained earlier, all the vertices whose the actual vertex is a prerequisite are in the stack. We can push the actual vertex. We are sure that it will come before its neighbors in the ordering. And we also need a non-recursive function, where we create a stack, the set of visited vertices, and we call the recursive function on every unvisited vertex. After it, we create an array ordering, and we keep popping from the stack and inserting in the array until the stack becomes empty. Then, we just return the topological ordering we were searching for. The recursive process of this algorithm is in reality a depth-first search, and depth-first search has an O of length of V plus length of E time complexity, while length of V is the number of vertices and length of E the number of edges. We also have popping length of V vertices from the stack while inserting them in the array, which costs O of length of V. The total is 2 times length of V plus length of E. We get a time complexity of O of length of V plus length of E. And for the space complexity, we need length of V extra space for the call stack, length of V for the stack, and length of V for the visited set. We get a space complexity of O of length of V. We reached the end of this video. I hope that you understood how does topological sort work. Like and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next one.